Hey everyone, welcome to CCL Hoxton Online. We're so happy you can join us this Sunday morning for a word and some worship. We meet here every Sunday at 10 a.m. and you can access the stream via any of our social links on YouTube, Facebook or Instagram at either CCL Hoxton or CCL Numa. You can also find the stream on our website, cclnuma.org, along with information on how you can give and lots of other information about our church and this campus. Feel free to also share the link with anyone you know that you want that wants to engage with their faith or receive some words of encouragement. And if you'd like to get involved with our weekend Bible study or any midweek groups, you can reach out to us using any of our social media channels. We'll get straight back to you and make sure that you get connected. And finally, as you're watching, don't forget to take pictures and share your experiences of church at home. And you can tag us using hashtag CCL at home. We look forward to sharing this time with you. And wherever you are, God bless you and enjoy the service.
In the presence of my enemies, I raise a hallelujah louder than the unbelief. I raise a hallelujah. My weapon is a melody. in the middle of the storm. Louder and louder, you're gonna hear my praises grow. Up from the ashes, hope will arise. Death is defeated, the King is alive. I'm gonna sing in the middle of the storm. Louder and louder, you're gonna hear my praises roar. Up from the ashes, hope will arise. Death is defeated, the King is alive. I raise a hallelujah. I raise a hallelujah. I raise a hallelujah. I raise a hallelujah.
I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my tomb till I met you. I was breathing but not alive. All my failures I tried to hide. It was my tomb till I met you.
You called my name and I ran out of that grave, out of the darkness into your glorious day.
Declare this right where you are, and you're going to repeat after me. Let's go.
I needed rescue, my sin was heavy, but chains break at the weight of your glory. I needed shelter, I was an orphan, but you called me a citizen of heaven.
When I was broken, you were my healing.
Your glorious day,
you call my
give you glory. For all you brought me through. And now I'm ready for whatever you wanna do. I'm moving forward to follow after you. And now I'm ready for whatever you wanna do. Declare it with me, your presence. Your presence is an open door. We want you, Lord, like never before. Let's declare it. Your presence is an open door. So come now, Lord, like never before. Every season, your praise has been enough. And I'm believing that the best is yet to come. Let's sing it. The cross before me, my hope on things above. And in you, Jesus, the best is yet to come. Come, let's declare it, your presence, Jesus. Your presence is an open door. I want you, Lord, like never before. Your presence, God, your presence is an open door. So come now, Lord. There where you are, I want you to just start declaring that breakthrough is coming. We're beginning a new year, and this year is going to be one of the best. So let's just declare it, that what He's promised, He will do. Sing it with me. 'Cause I know a breakthrough is coming. By faith, I see a miracle. My God, He made me a promise, and we won't stop now. Is more than enough, Jesus. Your presence is more than enough. There you are. Just say, Jesus, if I have you, I have everything. I believe in the truth of your word. I believe in those words that you have spoken to me, God. There where you are, just cry out to Jesus and say, your presence is enough. God, more. What you just want one day in your presence, God, and that's more than enough for us, God.
Oh, Jesus, 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 we believe, we believe, we believe. Declare with me. Yes, I know breakthrough is coming by faith. Oh, I see a miracle. My God, He made me a promise and we won't stop now. Declare this with me and your family. Yes, I know. Yes, I know by faith.
This is the year to shine, and we know that God will do great things in our lives. Thank you for connecting to our online service. These are this week's announcements.
Now we have a better way of donating. Simply go to cclnewmer.org and click donate. Enter the amount you would like to give, fill in the form, select the campus you belong to. If you are a UK taxpayer and you would like to gift aid your donation, please tick the box. Press give now, fill in your card details and press the blue button. We give a huge thanks to each one of you for your donation during these times.
Don't forget that our online groups are running throughout the week. If you'd like to be part of one of the groups, send us a message and we will put you in contact with one of them. It is important to maintain connected during these times. For us, it's a pleasure to have you here. We hope you enjoy the service.
Hey guys, good morning. It's such a pleasure to be able to come and share the word with you guys this morning. It's amazing to see that it's been a year now that we have been doing online church. It's been a year that we have, you know, been living with this whole situation of the pandemic. It's already been a year where, you know, we have had so many things happen throughout this entire year that, you know, it has been sad times, it's been good times, but above all, we can really say that God has been good. Above all, we can say that God has really been there for us and God has allowed us to come through even in the darkest moments. So this morning I want to share a message with you guys, a message that, to be honest, it will be encouraging, a message that maybe you probably heard once before, but it seems that every time I come and share the message with you guys, it's kind of like I'm always reminding you of something. But sometimes we need that, because we as Christians sometimes tend to fall into that conformity, that we're just so comfortable in our Christian life, we're so comfortable in our walk with God, that sometimes we forget the principles and we forget what God has told us once again. And God wants to remind us time and time again that His goodness is above all, that His sovereignty is above all in our lives, and He is always with us and He's walking beside us. So there where you are, let's give thanks to God. Let's pray this morning and let's just give Him the glory, because without Him, you and I would not be able to be here today. And you know, wherever you are with your family, with your spouse, maybe with your children, or just with your brothers or on your own, let's just give thanks to God for this time. Lord, we thank you for this moment. We thank you, Lord, for the privilege that we have, that we're able to share the gospel, Lord, and that we're able to receive the gospel as well, Lord. We're just thankful, God, because throughout this whole time, it's been a year where we have seen your goodness. It's been a year where we have seen your wonders. It's been a year where we have seen you work over and over again, even in the middle of the hardest moments of our life, even in the middle of those moments that we were never expecting, God, but you always manage to find a way to get us out and pull us through, Lord. We want to thank you in this time, God, and we just want to pray, Lord, for you to speak to our lives, speak to our hearts, encourage us, God, for whoever needs to hear this message, Lord, be encouraged today, Lord, to continue fulfilling and pursuing what it is that you have called them to do here on this earth, Lord. We love you, God, in the name of Jesus, amen. So the title of the message this morning, it's The Right Time. Why have I called it The Right Time? You will see in a little bit. So I don't know about you guys, but there has been many moments in my life, to be honest. I've kind of stopped doing that a lot recently because, you know, I've learned and I'm kind of dealing with that with God, that sometimes we, you know, we might want to have been born in a specific time. For example, maybe some of us were probably like wondering, oh, why wasn't I born in the 50s? Because I like this, or maybe the 60s or the 70s. You know, I'm a huge fan of the 80s. And even though I was born in 1990, I wished I was born a bit before that because, you know, of the music and all of these things. But God decided for me to be born in 1990. That was what he had designed to do. But many of us maybe I live in different stages in our life that we wished we were doing something else, maybe career-wise, or maybe, you know, personal life, or maybe, you know, if you're single, you wish to be married, or if you're married and you wish to have kids, and all of these sort of things. You know, sometimes as human beings, we tend to want to live maybe further along our lifetime or maybe in the past. And like I said, it's pretty normal. It happens to me all the time. And it's something that, you know, I sometimes question God. But then we understand something. We have to understand that there is a right time for everything. And even in the Bible, it tells us in Ecclesiastes, isn't it? There is a right time for everything. And God's timing is perfect. And sometimes you probably think, no, I've heard that before, but everyone speaks about that. Yes, God's timing is perfect. Or maybe you hear that one that's always there when it's like, oh, the good things come to those who wait and blah, blah, blah. But it's a constant thing. It's a constant thing that happens in a walk of life, right? That sometimes we're like, oh my God, we're so tired of waiting, or maybe things don't work out. But let me tell you something. You are where you are at this particular moment in time, in history, in the nation where you're watching me from, because I imagine there's loads of other people, not just from the UK, that are watching me today, but God has designed it to be for this particular time. So as I was doing this message and I was really meditating and thinking about this, there was loads of people in the Bible that we can see that were in the right time, in the right place at the right time. And I wanted to pinpoint three people. Obviously, there's loads of people in the Bible that, you know, we can read. You know, we've got David, we've got Joseph, we've got loads of different people. But there are three people that I really, really wanted to kind of concentrate on today, because their lives, although it made a difference in history, it made a difference in their time, but their lives personally, they're the ones that really, really impact me the most. So I really want to share this with you guys. And you know, like I said, these particular people, like many of us, were born in a particular time in history, you know, to bring change to the nation, to bring change to the world. You know, it wasn't a minute after or a minute before, it was the right time. So the first person that we are going to focus on, or we're going to look at, it's Queen Esther. Right, you probably hear this, you hear, you know, loads of preachings about Esther. She's this really famous queen that obviously, if you know her background, it's quite astonishing. So she is this young Jewish girl who was actually, you know, she was taken to captivity to the city in Susa, where obviously it was under the Persian kingdom, and she was an orphan. She was orphaned and she's been looked after by her uncle Mordecai. So she is, you know, an orphan girl. She is minding her own business. She is living her life. She is doing what she's doing. She's being taught by her uncle. You know, she's following the law of Moses. You know, she's been guided spiritually. She's been, you know, with her uncle training her in the ways of the Lord, I would like to say. And obviously, all of a sudden, there is this huge fiasco in the kingdom. You guys probably know the rest of the story. And if you guys don't, I encourage you guys to read the book of Esther. It's a fantastic book. It's one of the books of history, and it's just amazing because the story of Esther is one of my favorite ones, and it really, really, really catches my attention. So what happens is that obviously there is this huge fiasco in the kingdom with the queen, and the king decides that he's gonna get rid of her, divorce her, and then he's gonna appoint another queen. So this basically means that he has to call all of the young girls from the kingdom, and he is going to pick his bride. So what happens is that he doesn't pick his bride straight away. There is a process of 3 years that these young virgin girls had to go through in order to even have a time with the king so that he can pick them. So what happens is that, it's a three-year process. So Esther, in this case, she goes to the palace. She's prepared. So, the preparation was, I imagine, etiquette lessons, because these girls were probably not from the upper class. They had to bathe themselves in certain oils. It was a lot of preparation in order for them, to come and see the king. And the time comes 3 years later when she actually does get to meet the king. And then he decides that he wants to marry her, and he makes her Queen Esther. And the rest, as you say, is history. And they lived happily ever after. But that was just part of the story. But on the other part of the story, there was something that was happening behind closed doors that came to light. It was a conspiracy against the Jewish nation. Obviously, because there were foreigners in this particular nation, there was Haman was the one that saw them as a threat. So he wanted to exterminate, he wanted to get rid of them, he wanted to kind of put them aside. So what happens is this conspiracy is all uncovered, and Mordecai tells Queen Esther to please go and plead for the Jew's life. But Esther, she knew all the etiquette in the palace. You were not allowed to go and meet the king until you were summoned. So there is this verse that is very popular, that everyone knows, that we all say it, we all declare it, we all proclaim it, that says in Esther 4:14, and this is what Mordecai says to Esther, doesn't he? He says, "If you keep quiet at a time like this, deliverance and relief for the Jews will arise from some other place, but you and your relatives will die. Who knows if perhaps you were made queen for such a time as this." Powerful statement from Uncle Mordecai. I could just imagine Esther just going through so many things in her head. But, one, I'm an orphan. Two, it was just luck that I came into the palace. It was kind of just like, I could just imagine all sort of things going through her head at this point. But he said something that specific, and he actually said, when he says, "Perhaps you were made queen for such a time as this." This is where we understand that God's timing is perfect. And in this particular case with Esther, she was brought to the kingdom. She was made queen for this particular time. So what happened later, as you guys know the story, because she went in front of the king, she wasn't summoned, she just went. She risked her life for her people, and she was able to bring her people, bring them deliverance. They were not murdered, they were not killed, that nothing happened to them, thanks to Queen Esther. And even up until now, the Jewish nation celebrates this as one of its feasts, and its Purim, which is basically when they were saved from this mass holocaust that could have happened in those days. And God used a woman. God used an orphan. And there's a reason why I'm doing this. God used someone that had no parents. God used someone that was probably, to her, she probably thought nothing of herself. But God decided to take her for such a time as this. God needed her in the palace 3 years later, after she was picked to be a part of, to be queen. 3 years later, God took her to the palace in order for her to be, the deliverer of the Jewish people in that moment. And it is amazing to see how God started putting two and two together in order for her to fulfill her purpose as the deliverer, let's say that way, of the Jewish nation at that particular time in history. Coincidence? Maybe not. I don't think there was a coincidence. God had it all planned out that even in his great sovereignty, although there was pain in the nation, God lifted up somebody that believed in what she, in what God had told her, that believed in everything that she had, you know, the responsibility that came upon her, and she went and made things happen. And because of her, they were delivered. It is amazing. We can learn so much from this story, and I really encourage you guys to read this through. So that's Queen Esther. Now we're going to look at the second person, which is one of the most important people in the whole wide world. Thanks to him, you and I are here today. Thanks to him, we are able to share about his life. And the second person is Jesus. And I put these, the three people that I'm going to share about, I put them in chronological order. Okay, so obviously Esther was before Christ, and now we are coming to Jesus. So the second person I want to talk to you guys about is Jesus. So Jesus, you know, he was born at a time that was perfect. I don't know about you guys, I question this again. I question a lot of things. I like to let my mind run wild sometimes, and I question the silliest things. And I kind of sometimes, you know, think what would it be if Jesus was born during this time? I wonder how things would have been very different if Jesus was born now. And I think one of the things that would have been very different is that we would not be living in 2021. We'd probably be living like the Jewish calendar in the year 5781. So we would still be waiting for that, the promised Messiah. So we'd still be kind of counting and counting and counting. So that would be one of the main differences. When Jesus came onto this earth, even from the day that he was born, he already made a difference. From the day that he was born, the calendars shifted. It stopped being before Christ. It started being Anno Domini, which basically means in the year of the Lord. And that basically means in the year of Jesus's birth, the year that Jesus was born. He made a difference in the whole universe, not just, you know, like I said, not just to people, but even to the whole calendar system. Because obviously from then on, we started in year zero and up until today, 2021. How amazing that one person, God used one person to bring so much change to humanity. And obviously it doesn't even stop there. We all know what Jesus did. We all know what he came to do. But it is amazing to see that he came at the right time. The people of Israel, obviously, as you guys know, they were living under the Jewish law, which meant that they had to do so many things in order for them to be saved. That's what we know as the law. However, when Jesus came, he came to break the law, and he came at the exact time. Galatians 4:4 tells us, but when the right time came, again, we see that phrase again, when the right time came, God sent his son, born of a woman, subject to the law. God sent him to buy freedom for us who were slaves to the law, so that he could adopt us as his very own children. Jesus came to free the people from the bondage of the law, to give them salvation so that he can adopt us as his children. And it is amazing because God did it at the right time. He came at the right time. When Jesus was walking on earth, he even said, and he says, yes, the time is now. The kingdom of heaven has come upon you. He was proclaiming the good news everywhere, declaring that it was the right time that he was there doing his ministry. If you remember again, Jesus had a moment, not even a moment, he had 30 years of preparation where he was being prepared by God in everything. It says that Jesus grew in wisdom, not just in height, but also in wisdom in the word of God. He grew up in so many levels to become the person that God intended him to be. At 30 years old and for 3 years, he made such an impact to this whole world, that he obviously, you know, he came to fulfill the purpose which he was sent for. And he did so at the right time. God did not, you know, he did not decide him to, for him to come in 2021 or maybe in Esther's time. No, God decided it to be at the right time. The day he was born, it was marked zero in the calendar. And from then on, there was a difference from before and after Jesus. He knew that he was here coming on this earth to fulfill a specific purpose. He was sent by God. Again, God determined the right time for Jesus to rise up and to do what he had to do. Like I said, there was a time of preparation. There was a time where he had to build himself up. There was a time that even he learnt the skill of his father, Joseph. He was a human like us, but yet he came at the right time to make a difference on this earth and give you salvation and allow us to have eternal life through his death and resurrection. And the person number three that we're going to talk about. So we've been talking about Esther, we spoke about Jesus, and now we're going to be talking about Paul the Apostle. I feel like he's my best friend. We've been studying Paul in Bible classes with my group. And it's just amazing, the life of Paul. When you study his life, when you study his letters, you really start to get a glimpse at the amazing grace of God. So I encourage you guys, I'm doing a little ad break here. If you guys want to get involved in our Bible study groups, please let us know, comment below, and we will get back to you, because studying the Word of God brings us so much. We're able to go so much in depth and we can understand the scriptures a lot more. So we're going to talk about Paul the Apostle. You guys know the story. He was the persecutor of the church. He came, he had an encounter with Jesus himself. Obviously, it was after his resurrection. He did not personally walk with Jesus, talk with Jesus. No, he didn't. But again, he had the conversion. He converted himself. He converted to Jesus and believed in the grace of God. And from then on, he was appointed by God to become the apostle to the Gentiles. So thanks to him as well. Thanks to the amazing calling that God put upon Paul. You and I have the privilege and the blessing that we're able to accept and to know the promises of God and to accept and know Jesus as our Savior because of him, that he was able to spread the word all around the empire. And it was amazing. Again, this guy was not just anyone. He was brought up in the ways of the Lord. But with this particular case, he was brought up in the ways of the Lord in the strict law. Like, he literally was, you know, he was a Pharisee. So he was a teacher of the law. He was a rabbi and he knew what he was teaching. He knew the law of Moses and he knew what he was talking about. But when he had that encounter with Jesus, his life completely changed. And it was at that particular time. It wasn't, you know, when he was not walking with Jesus, it was after Jesus had died and resurrected that God appointed him. Why? Because God needed to get this guy to spread the gospel to the Gentiles. I want you guys to understand, and I really do hope that you guys are getting the idea behind each and every story that I'm telling you. Because again, he was appointed at a specific time. And he was quite old at that time. He was in his 40s almost when he had the encounter with Jesus. So he had about 40 years before that of a lot of training, a lot of rigorous mentality that he had, religious mentality that God was able to break down in a second, because God needed him to go and reveal and give them the revelation that he had, that Jesus had given to him about the gospel of grace. And Galatians 1 11 onwards, he tells us a little bit about his story. So he's speaking to the Galatians and he's telling them where he came from, and it's amazing to see how God took these people. He took these people that, you know, maybe their background wasn't great, let's say, in the eyes of man, but their background was messy. But yet he took them and made them into something amazing. And this is what he says. Dear brothers and sisters, I want you to understand that the gospel message I preach is not based on human reasoning. I received my message not from human source, and no one taught me. Instead, I received it by direct revelation from Jesus Christ. What a privilege. You know that what I was like when I followed the Jewish religion, how I violently persecuted God's church. I did my best to destroy it. I was far ahead of my fellow Jews in my zeal for the traditions of my ancestors. But before I was born, God chose me and called me by his marvelous grace. Then it pleased him to reveal his son to me. We see that again. We see that time frame again. So that I would proclaim the good news about Jesus to the Gentiles. When this happened, I did not rush out to consult with any human being. It is amazing. We see that time frame again. Then it pleased him to reveal his son to me. That was that time frame, that right time when God needed him. He knew the Jewish traditions. He was this guy that persecuted the church, religious guy, but God needed him at that particular time so that he can share the gospel to the Gentiles, to the people that were non-Jewish. Titus 1:2 tells us, this truth then gives confidence that they have eternal life in which God does not lie, promised them before the world began. And now, at just the right time, he has revealed this message which we announce to everyone. It is for the command of God our Savior that I have been entrusted with this work for him. Again, it's speaking about, you know, this particular verse is speaking about how at the right time the message came to the Gentiles at that particular time. And something that literally just came to my mind right now. There are many people that say, oh, I wish I had met the Lord when I was younger. Or I wish, you know, I had met God when I was a teenager or this. And now I'm in my 30s and I'm in my 40s, you know, and my life, I've done so many things with my life. Let me tell you something. Again, at just the right time, the message was revealed to you so that you could announce it to everyone at just the right time. If God wanted you to know him when you were younger, he would have done that. But if God wanted to call you at the particular age that he called you, it's because he's going to use your past, your background, your, you know, your mess and turn it into his message. Because that's what God is doing in this time. God needs people like you and I that are ready to take on that responsibility at just the right time. So that with your mess, with your background, with whatever it is that you probably think, oh, I'll just have this and that, whatever. God is going to use that to you, to so it can be your message. We've heard about that a lot of times, haven't we? But God is using this time, for this time, God has called you to spread the word or whatever it is that God is telling you to do in this time. The reason why I share the life of these three people that have personally really, really impacted my life is to understand that God's timing was perfect. God used an orphan girl at the perfect time to become queen, which was probably practically impossible, guys. A Jewish queen in a Persian kingdom to bring freedom to the Jews. A Jewish boy born from a virgin, rejected at birth from many people, from even his own father at first, Joseph, to become the savior of the world. A persecutor of the church, a killer, a murderer, a religious leader, to become one of the greatest apostles in our time. Can you see the chain? Can you see what God does at just the right time? So let me tell you something. No matter what you're going through, no matter the process that God is allowing you to go through, because even in the bad times, God is there. God is molding you for something greater. And you're probably tired of hearing this, but I'm going to tell you again. And I get tired of hearing it all the time. Where they're like, yes, you know, it's coming, it's coming. I get tired. But there is 1 ounce of hope in my heart that I know that God's plans are greater for my life than my own, that I could have made so many mistakes in my past, but God aligned my steps, like the Word of God says, but we can make so many plans, but God aligns our steps for this particular time, because the time will come, the time is coming, where God is going to show you why He didn't allow you to do those things. Or He's going to show you why you had to wait for so long for certain things to happen. God is going to do it. Or God is going to show you why He allowed you to be born for this time. Why He allowed you to be in this country for this particular time. God will reveal it all in due course. Just follow through the process that God is allowing you to go through. And I want to finish with this verse that we've heard again. Every time, I just want you guys to get something. Even though you hear the same message time and time again, don't discard it and be like, oh, I've heard it before. I've heard that verse before. Oh, it's just so normal. Everyone uses it. No, but every time you hear it, and it's happened to me, it is at a particular time when I needed a reminder of God at that time that He's speaking to me. So don't disregard the words that God is speaking to us right now, even if you've heard them a million times. And I'm going to read this to you once again. Jeremiah 29:11, and this message is for someone out there that needs to hear this today. And the Word of God says, "For I know the plans that I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good and not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope." The time is coming at the right time, at the appointed time. Stick with those words in your mind. Stick with those words at that moment. Yes, the time is coming. For such a time as this, God is going to reveal Himself to you in ways that you had never imagined. I just pray that this message was a blessing to your lives. And as we pray right now, as we give thanks to God, and if you've never heard the message of Jesus today, let me tell you something. God has a plan for your lives. Maybe you're tired of hearing it, yes. But let me tell you something. Jesus has a plan for your life. He came on this earth to die for you and I, to give us that path to eternal life. So one day we can live forever. Once we die on this earth, we're going to live forever in His glory together with Jesus. So I want you there where you are. Just close your eyes and just do this small prayer with me and thank Jesus for allowing you to listen to this message today, to remind you that what no matter your past, God is going to give you a better future, a brighter future. Because for such a time as this, God has brought you into His kingdom so you can hear the word and you can share it to others around you. So just pray with me. Lord Jesus, I thank you for this time, and I pray that you open my heart to receive you in my life as my Lord and Savior. I want to live with you forever, God, and I just pray that you fill me with your peace and your love, and let your peace and your love surround me all days of my life. In the name of Jesus, amen. And if you've done this prayer for the first time, I pray and I ask that you put your name down in the comments. We'll be looking out for you so that we are able to reach out to you guys. And I just want to finish off again with just a small prayer for you, my friend, that are listening to me, my friend, my brother, my sister, that are listening to me today. God has great plans for all of us. Although there's a process that we have to go through, Jesus had a 30-year process. Paul had a 40-year process, even more. Esther had a 3-year process, you know, even from when she was a little girl, maybe even more. But God took them to be at the right time, in the right place. The right place in the right time. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you. We just want to understand that your timing is perfect. There is a time for everything, like your word says. And we believe that you have the best for us, Lord. Allow us to continue with that understanding, that in-depth understanding that you have the best for us, Lord. And there is nothing more than we want, that we want, God, than just to understand your timings in our life, God. We know that you make all things new, even though you turn our messes into our messages, God, and you allow us to share the word with people around us, Lord. We love you, and we just want to give you all the glory and all the praise. In the name of Jesus, amen. Thank you so much for connecting with us this morning. Don't forget, we have our groups running throughout the week, and we love to see you soon. Bye.